Cities. More than half of us live in one. They also account for 70% of our global CO2 emissions and over half of our waste. So the question is, can they become green, clean, and truly sustainable? We're off on a journey with Hyundai Ioniq to see how communities are rising to the challenge. I'm James Stewart. I'm a TV host, I'm an environmentalist, and I talk quite a lot about climate change and our changing planet. Okay, we need to talk about energy. You see, cities use a lot of it. 3/4 of all global energy, in fact. If we want sustainable cities, then we need clean ways of powering them. So we've come to Los Angeles, where currently half the energy used here is from renewable sources, with a commitment to make that 100% by 2045. To show me around, we got in touch with local expert Ashley Christie, director of Grid Alternatives LA.
James, you made it!
Hey, Ashley!
Oh my goodness, such a beautiful day to welcome you to sunny California.
Look at this!
I know.
The sunshine, what a view!
I wanted to bring you to the energy capital of Southern California.
Oh,
shall we
wait.
Do it?
Jump in!
Welcome.
We made it.
Good to see you again.
Good to see you again, Tom. This is my friend James.
Nice to meet you. James, good to meet you.
Look at this.
I know, right?
The largest turbine out here today will power 1,500 homes a year.
One.
Just from one wind turbine.
Yeah. You don't think of Los Angeles in wind, do you, really?
Well, California is not a windy state, right?
Nope.
I mean, the only reason that we have wind turbines here is because we have an ocean to our west, we have a desert to the east, so you've got hot air, which is less dense, you've got the cool, dense air, so there's this natural flow, but these two mountain peaks in the
there
area,
it is.
They create this natural funnel of venturi right through the mountain, and that's where the wind comes. But basically, the energy in this area eventually ends up going into Los Angeles, because it takes all this infrastructure to support the city. All of these machines pay back their carbon footprint within about 6 to 7 months. Solar panels, I think, in about 9 months. After that, it's all a net positive. Wind and the sun are the cheapest ways of adding new electricity.
What a great idea.
That's why I brought you here, right? Makes sense.
You can't, your brain kind of can't, every time you think you've seen them all, there's more. It's like looking out into an ocean.
Yep.
It never ends. An ocean of clean energy.
As you can see, it's really hot out here.
Yeah.
We live in sunny Southern California.
100 degrees.
100 degrees. So we need a lot of power. All of the sources of energy other than green energy are expensive. They pollute everything. And that's a problem in our communities, especially a place like Los Angeles. A lot of transportation, a lot of things. So it's great that we're doing our part by driving in this vehicle here.
Yeah.
But, you know, this is part of the solution to make it easier to be able to get all of the energy we need.
But it's all very well and good having this stuff, but we also do need to have a more decentralized way of doing this, don't we?
Yeah, we're doing this on a large scale, and I think we have to adopt this technology faster.
Yeah.
And, you know, on a scale that everybody can contribute to. So I wanted to show you kind of how we go from this to something more manageable for the everyday consumer.
Green energy LA style.
Yep, let's head west.
Let's head west.
The vast solar and wind farms in the desert are a huge part of the clean energy transition, but change is happening in the city itself, one home at a time, creating a more decentralized grid are just as important. To get a sense of what this smaller scale setup looks like, Ashley took us to the Hyundai Home mock-up.
Hey, Ian.
Hello there.
This is my friend, Jane.
How are you?
Ian.
Lovely to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Welcome to our Hyundai Home. So this really is a model of everything that we offer through the Hyundai Home service, which is how we as Hyundai help customers electrify their lives. And so as our vehicles electrify and the transportation network electrifies, it just makes sense for us to take the load off of the main grid with these kinds of, say, residential setups.
As people living in cities, it's important for us to do our part to make sure we can contribute to a transition to green energy, doing one little thing at a time. And like he says, you can go from just having a charger to power your EV, or you can do the whole suite of things to really help give energy back to the grid for your community.
It just sounds fun as well. You get to make your own electricity. It's like a science experiment at school.
It really is.
Come on, so.
And the tour.
Yes, the grand tour of our tiny house.
It won't take long, though.
Yes, exactly.
What I find exciting about this is that people become energy producers, not just consumers. Every homeowner can become a part of this clean energy revolution taking place. Or can they? Is everyone actually included and benefiting? It was time to meet some of the people Ashley works with and see a side of the city which gets a bit less attention.
One of the main ways we do is through our renewable energy lens, and we install, you know, solar at no cost to families that Incredible. Are often left behind and are in some of the most impacted and marginalized communities in Los Angeles.
We did it. We're here.
There it is. Look at that.
I know, this is an install.
This is work.
This is what we do every day in the community. There's your hard hat, as promised, so you put it on.
That's coming home with me.
You're in good hands.
Thank you, sir. Thanks, Ashley.
Of course.
Wish me luck. Hey, guys. How you doing? This is much higher than I thought it was going to be.
Ashley. How are you guys doing today?
Good.
Awesome, awesome. We're here and we're about to graduate. We're doing our first install. Being able to contribute to renewable footprint.
Yeah,
and in my community.
Awesome.
In the communities that can benefit the most from it, and then that don't even really know about solar.
Okay, and that's going into here,
yes,
right?
Oh, sorry.
Okay, that's good. Wow!
At Grid, we are so proud to do things from small homes to larger projects, especially one that I'm really proud of is one we did at Gonzales Park in Compton. This park was kind of unsafe for kids, not really well kept by the city, and we were able to electrify it so that people can have nicer places to play. And I think you can't do it by yourself, and it takes, you know, the old saying, it takes a village, right?
Yes.
So it takes the larger community to do this work and to make it meaningful for everyone and including everyone.
Speaking of partnerships, mm-hmm. I have a little surprise for you now.
You have a surprise
for me. I have a surprise. Well, you've done so much for me today.
My goodness.
I feel like I owed you one back. I want to take you to meet my friend Graham. He's involved in a project called the Carbonauts. It's all about helping businesses live more sustainably through education, exactly what you're into.
Awesome.
And I couldn't come to Hollywood and not watch some movies. So we might
I love a movie.
A little movie night. All right.
This is us.
We're here. Graham.
What's up?
How are you, my man? Good to see you again. Ashley, Graham, Ashley.
Hi, Graham.
Thank you.
Nice to meet you. Heard a lot about you.
Oh, yeah. We got a great backyard, do a little screening. I was told that this one, you can actually plug other things into it or something like that.
You plug it into mm-hmm. this one.
Bam.
Yeah, probably a shirt.
Okay.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, my gosh.
Yes.
I didn't do anything. Yeah.
As the sun sets on another amazing day, we had a chance to reflect. LA is a story of what can happen when you get enough people, resources, organizations, and innovators behind the same cause. But it's also a story of inequality. Without the work of community groups and organizations, many people are excluded from this clean energy movement and the benefits it provides. It's another reminder that our road to sustainable cities, wherever that may lead, must be wide enough to bring everyone along.